didn't have a clue who you were. As a matter of fact, I got you wrong on the highlight package. I called you Mozart.
This video will be music to 49ers fans' ears, or anyone who enjoys an underdog story. It's a tale of never giving up. After going undrafted, Raheem Mostert wasn't given a single carry in the NFL until his seventh team. Now he's composed a masterpiece of a game in one of the greatest playoff performances of all time. And soon he'll be returning to his home state to play in the Super Bowl. Mostert grew up in a beach town in Florida. With all the surfing and skating he did, a representative from Billabong once approached him with a contract to compete in events around the country. He didn't take up that offer, but he has said action sports and football require a similar skill set. He said, "You're in a wave and at that moment you want to make a decision, whether you want to do a trick, flare up, do a nice trick and land, or just ride the wave out." That's the same thing with football. There are a lot of different angles. Sometimes you have to split two defenders. Sometimes you don't want to go out of bounds. You get the point. Still, 350-pound defensive tackles can't quite compete with a shark fin heading straight for your board, which Mostert said once happened. He compared the sharks to football and said you try not to think about the potential dangers. Even on land, Mostert keeps that surfing background with him as his signature touchdown celebration. Back in high school, Mostert played wide receiver. And as a 2- or 3-star recruit, I've seen both grades, he committed to Purdue. And he didn't make the transition to running back until his junior year of college. His biggest mark on the Boilermakers didn't even come on the football field. He was a Big Ten champion in the 60 and 200 meter for the track team. NFL.com actually ranked him the fastest player in college football back in 2014. So, on the field, he was used largely as a returner before finally picking up some notable rushing yards as a senior. And even still, 1 year before entering the NFL, 529 yards in the season isn't really going to send you up any draft boards. His final college totals were 759 rushing yards and 122 receiving yards. Clearly, his special teams capabilities were the only path to get his foot in the door on an NFL roster. Even with that track speed, Mostert didn't perform very well in the combine. So now when you add on those results with his college production, there wasn't any real chance of getting drafted. 23 running backs were selected in the 2015 NFL Draft, including current Niners running back Tevin Coleman. Mostert was left hoping a team would take a chance on him after the draft. That team would be the Eagles, and he impressed in the preseason with 351 yards of total offense. Unfortunately, that still wouldn't be enough. He was part of the final roster cuts, but the Eagles did sign him to their practice squad. It was only 8 days before the Dolphins poached him off the Eagles. He returned a few kickoffs for them, but then they tried to move him to their practice squad. And that didn't work because the Ravens picked him up next. Baltimore did the same special teams then practice squad strategy. And once again, he was swiped. This time the Browns snagged him. We are now up to 4 teams in 1 year. He played on special teams for the final few games. Then the next year he finally made a 53-man roster and celebrated with his family, only to be cut the next day.
I got immune to, you know, being cut. And I just wanted, you know, I wanted to show the world what I can do.
You can add the Jets and Bears to the list before Mostert finally found his home in San Francisco. In November 2016, the Niners added him as a, stop me if you've heard this one before, a practice squad player. He did play one game for them that year and had his first career rush for 6 yards. That's right, this running back got his first career carry on his 7th NFL team. In 2017, he played 11 games but eventually made his way to injured reserve. That year, he was almost strictly special teams. 2018 would be the year where he would begin his transformation into an NFL running back. Ironically, he played less games than the year prior, but this season was needed for his development. Week 6 versus who other than?
The Green Bay Packers.
Mostert was given a career-high 12 carries. He finally got the opportunity and ran for it for 87 yards. A couple weeks later, he scored his first touchdown on a 52-yard run, but it seems like every time this man runs into success, he also hits a roadblock. In that same game he scored his first touchdown, Mostert also broke his arm. But the 49ers still liked what they saw out of this kid. They signed him to a 3-year deal during the offseason. From weeks 1 to 12 this year, Mostert averaged just under 36 yards per game, even though he was still doing well with what he was given. Then in week 13 against the Ravens, one of his former teams, Mostert had his breakout game. He was finally given an RB1 workload and rushed for 146 yards. He said playing the Ravens definitely added some extra meaning to the game. I was there with the organization. I tried to prove to that organization that I was worth something to stay there, for them to keep me. But that's the life of an NFL player. You get the ups and downs in life, but you just have to keep pressing. The next week against the Saints, he did keep pressing in a game that would shift around playoff seedings dramatically. He once again ran efficiently and added a couple touchdowns in the win. Still, he shared the backfield with Tevin Coleman and never reached the amount of volume he received in that Ravens game. Once again, all he needed was opportunities. And with the team trending more and more toward a rush-first attack, the playoffs could present the perfect occasion. San Fran had the number one seed and they blew things open on the Vikings behind the great rushing attack of Tevin Coleman. Coleman was the one with 22 carries, 105 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Mostert had just 12 carries for 58 yards as he was dealing with some cramps. By no means was that a bad performance, but Coleman definitely stole the show. The next game with a trip to the Super Bowl on the line, San Francisco once again turned to their rushing game. Coleman tragically dislocated his shoulder, so it was up to Mostert to carry the team. This former special teams journeyman blew up the Packers just like he did the year prior. But this time with the stakes so much bigger, so too was his production. At times it felt like the offense became a one-man band. Mostert became the first player to ever score 4 touchdowns and rush for over 200 yards in a playoff game. He went from bouncing from team to team to bouncing off defenders on his way to the Super Bowl. After the game, he said, "You know, honestly, I just woke up like it was any other game. It was one of those things where, hey, once we all got in a groove, we're just gonna keep it riding, keep it going, and that's what we did." It was a groove he always had. He just needed to be trusted. There was no bigger stage to be given that trust than a game with a trip to the Super Bowl on the line. With Jimmy Garoppolo throwing just 8 passes in a contest over by halftime, it shows just how much this 17 veteran fueled the 37-point explosion that sent the 49ers to their 7th Super Bowl. This time there won't be any Joe Montana or Steve Young behind center, but this team has Raheem Mostert. And he composed a playoff performance that will live on in history, just like the greats who came before him in that red and white uniform. Comment your predicted score of the Super Bowl right now. We'll see who gets it right. The Niners have blown out both teams they've faced so far, but that Chiefs offense looks just unstoppable when its wheels get turning. I think it has the potential to be a fantastic game. And as always, please remember to like and sub it up for more NFL videos.
I've got the Texans by 24. Oh, wait.